Divine Truth Assistance Group. Group assistance sessions putting principles of divine truth into action. This recording is from the Understanding God's Love and Laws group and is part of an Education in Love series. In the Human Law Hangover presentation, Mary analyzes the previous human law comparison and highlights the human individual and collective attitudes, feelings, and emotions towards God's laws that have come from a human law hangover. Recorded on the 23rd of November, 2016, in Noosaville, Queensland, Australia.
All right, guys. Well, for the next 40 minutes or so, I'm going to be speaking with you about this topic of the human law hangover. So who here has ever been drunk? Vast majority of us. Only about three of us who haven't. So from those, the vast majority, can you tell me what it's like when you start to get drunk? How do you start to feel? Laura? Just keep your hand up, yep. And anyone on this side? No? You have to go to Kathy on that side after Laura.
Start to feel lightheaded.
Yep. Lightheaded, okay. So we have some physical sensations. What happens to us a bit emotionally if we go to Kathy?
I often start to feel more confident and brave and clear.
Yes, yeah. Everything's clearer and I'm more confident. And yep. If we come to Adria and then back to Laura.
We drop our facade a little bit. We are more honest, more...
Yeah, we can be more honest, yes. Yeah. Sometimes we throw a bit more truth in there, yep.
More shame.
Yeah. Laura?
Yeah, so just going, I guess it's a similar to the confidence thing, but you sort of drop your fears and just, you know, go for it.
Yeah, you sort of start to think you're a bit invincible, don't you?
Yeah.
I can do anything. Let's do this thing that's really awesome. It's like yesterday when I was clean sober, I would never think of doing, but now it's the best idea in the world. You know, let's ride a surfboard on top of the car through the streets, you know. Yep. This is the best thing ever. So we start to feel really confident and we think we've got it all together, don't we? And we think we're invincible. But are we really in touch with reality? Are we really invincible? No. Are we really even like conscious really of what's going on around us? No. Not at all. Then the next morning comes. Who's had a killer hangover? All those same people. Okay, who can tell me what it's like the next morning when you've got the hangover? Eloisa? And on this side we'll go to Marie.
You wish you'd never done the thing you did the day before.
Yep. Yeah,
if you remember it.
You start to feel regret, don't you? And you start to wonder, what did I do? Yeah. Marie?
You feel really guilty and try and track what the hell went down there.
Yeah. So guilt and shame start emerging, don't they? Yeah. Nikki?
So you feel like you just want to delete that day of your life out.
Yep. You almost get very resistive to the truth of what happened, don't you? You want denial because the alternative is shame. And sometimes, has anyone had this thing where you look in your wallet and you go, where did all the money go? Or you roll over in bed and go, what happened? So there's a lot of consequences that come up, isn't there, in the hangover but you don't want them. You don't go, oh, wow, that's what I did. You go, oh, that's what I did. You know, it's a yucky feeling, isn't it? Let alone the physical feelings. So in your outlines, we've said to you that we're all here drunk on the human perception of law. So if you follow on from what we've just discussed, if you think of what we're drinking, it's not alcohol now, it's the world's definition of love and law, isn't it? So we call the world's definition of love in the first couple of assistance groups, what do we call that? Evol. So we're drinking up all this evol all our life and applying that to what law is or how it's enacted. And we're starting to feel pretty confident about it, aren't we? In fact, we feel pretty invincible. I've got this sorted out and I'm doing good. Just like Jesus was speaking to you about in that previous discussion. We feel pretty good about ourselves. And we're not really aware of any negative consequences. And then what happens when we start to hear some of God's truth? Some of those other feelings start coming up, don't they? Start to feel a bit of pain, a bit of shame, a bit of like, oh, there's consequences? What did I do? And it starts to be a bit of a hangover, doesn't it? And for some of us, that even starts before we even hear some of God's truth, doesn't it? We start to accrue pain in our life and we're going, gee, what's going on? I'm feeling bad. I'm feeling regret. And this is what we want to highlight to you. This is your opportunity now to start to reflect on some of the emotions that you have about God's law versus human law in this discussion, to start to be sensitive to your hangover. Yeah, because of course we're interpreting all of human law as if it's truth, but it's almost like we're drunk and we're hungover at the same time, aren't we? We're completely sort of denying both states most of the time. Yeah, okay. Bex, you had a question?
Yeah, I realised when I got truth at the start of the week that this week's felt like a massive sobering up. That's what I was thinking even before thinking of the hangover. And it's like really hard and you feel foggy and gross, but it's also a wee bit relieving.
Yeah, because you have a chance now to stop drinking it in, don't you? Yeah, yeah. All right, so let's have a look at what we want to discuss with you guys. So you'll see at the start of your outlines, we've talked about your personal pain. And we've said that since childhood, all of us have been exposed only to parent and societal law. Now, a lot of us think, well, that was the painful bit. And for a lot of us, that has been painful, being exposed to parental and societal law. That is where a lot of our pain was created. But it's not always in the way that we think. Like sometimes there was a lot of injustice and a lack of permanence and consistency and things, and that created some pain and confusion. But then for others of us in the audience, we were given a lot of what we wanted all of the time, weren't we? And that didn't feel so bad at the time, but now when we get out of the family unit and we're in broader society, we can't always get that all the time. And then we start to feel a bit of pain. Yeah. So I've developed attitudes towards law, human's law and God's law that come from that childhood experience. And these things cause me pain and heartache, whether I want to be sensitive to it or not. So if I want to be happy, all I've got to do is examine this hangover that I've got and start to make some changes. All right. So as you've just been through with Jesus, you're examining how your attitudes affect your relationship with God's law and principles. Human and parental law has created attitudes, emotions, beliefs within me about law and principle, God's laws and principles, that harm my perception, this is the drunk bit, and ability to engage my will to be obedient to God's laws. So now I want to go, now let's look at some of those. All right, so this is where I'd like to hear from you guys. Let's have a look at this comparison here. So God's laws say God is the lawmaker and the enforcer and fully enforces obedience to every law. When it comes to humankind, the lawmaker is usually not the same person as the enforcer or group of people as the policing officers, and the law enforcer is not able to fully enforce obedience to any law created. So, what do you guys feel about that? Kate?
You just try to get away with what you can.
Yeah. Yeah, you start to think, well, look, there's all these different players here. I'm just going to do what I can and dodge all of them. Mm. Yeah, yeah. Anyone else? Rachel?
Feels like there's not necessarily love behind the law enforcement. They're just doing their job.
Yeah, so how do you feel, kind of? You feel... sometimes that feels sort of, it can feel like you're uncared for, can't it?
Yeah.
Or you can feel angry, like you're just doing this out of some other thing, not love.
It's not right.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel right somehow.
Yep. Anyone else have any reflections about that? Barbara? And if we go to Joyce on that side.
Because of those feelings, there's a lack of respect for the law enforcers then.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of times police officers are really regarded as very harshly, aren't they, by us. Yeah. And Joyce?
Feelings that most laws... That better?
Yeah.
Feeling that I have to obey through fear, because if I don't, I'm going to be in so much trouble.
Yeah, so fear becomes your motivator.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even if I disagree with the law.
Yeah. 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 Okay. Anyone else? If we go to Laura.
Yeah, there's also this feeling that I've felt from a few sort of police officers that there's this real arrogance that they have, like a real sort of power trip thing, and sometimes it feels like they do it just to get that kick out of it.
Yep.
Yeah.
To feel powerful. And how does that make Laura feel?
Yeah, oh, it makes me feel...
That fires Laura up a fair bit, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, it does. Yeah, I know.
So you feel pretty angry about that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you feel angry about somebody exerting power for power's sake.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You don't want to feel less than...
Yeah.
Definitely. What do you think it does? So that's how we feel about the human lawmakers and enforcers. How do we feel about God's laws because of this? How do we feel about God because of this? If we go to Sherry.
I just start to feel really frightened about the extent of and how refined it is. Like, I think about the thoughts and just feel... Just going to some sort of just afraid, really.
Meltdown, yeah. That's more when you hear from Jesus about God himself. It's not so much about the fact that on earth you can get away with it, is it?
No. But I guess knowing that I'm actually not getting away with anything, and then when you see that, then I start to really freak out.
Freak out about everything. Yeah, cool. All right, let's see another one. All right. From God's perspective, the lawmaker and enforcer is infinitely and always aware, perfect and infallible. Whereas on earth, what we experience is that the lawmaker or law enforcers and police have little awareness, are able to fail and are imperfect. So what beliefs, attitudes and emotions do I have about this? Lani?
I believe I can get away with it.
Yeah.
Yeah, if no one's watching, I, and even with God, I feel it too.
Yes, it's so true, isn't it? That this is the relationship I was alluding to earlier. Because these guys are fallible, we start to believe just automatically this guy's infallible.
Yeah,
I'll just
do this, that won't, I'll get away with that.
Yes. Yeah.
Finding out it doesn't work.
Yeah, definitely. If you pass forward to Vex, and on this side, if we go to Marie again. Yeah.
I reflected on what Jesus said yesterday about like kicking a man when he's down, and how with police, like maybe a few percent have had racist shootings, and the whole world and us and media are so quick to blame and jump on all the police rather than look at our own issues inside. And I realise I've been massively doing that all my life.
Yeah, definitely. It's easy to just say, oh, they are doing... And wouldn't it be hard to wake up as a police officer when some of your colleagues have done something that's really violent and unloving and go, wow, I've got to go to work today and how's everyone going to feel about me? And yet if all of us looked at, well, gee whiz, how do I support racism, for example... And that was just played out on the news. Yeah, definitely. It's easy to judge, to push away. Yeah. Okay, Marie?
Making that judgment, I go into, I'm superior and entitled, and I have never considered God's laws before this course.
Yeah, interesting. Who else had that experience where you realised, yeah, look, I haven't even really thought about God's laws before? Well, like that there's a guy with laws that are like totally, he's totally aware and infallible, the whole thing, and I've never even considered that that's the case. Yeah, Yeah. Who else? If we go to Monique, and then on this side we'll go to, oh, we'll go to Elvira on that side, yeah.
Thinking that God's not aware, and that unless I'm policed by God, I'm getting away with everything.
Yeah.
Or getting policed by you guys.
That, yeah. That sin doesn't exist unless it's sort of in pointed out in my face. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Okay, Elvira.
I often feel like because the police aren't always consistent that I'm not safe.
Yeah. 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 This whole thing we've been bringing up with you in the foundation principles about how it really creates a sense of safety. And yet a lot of us have, because we know that they're able to fail and they can get it wrong, we can feel like, well, what if I'm falsely accused? Or what if something happens to me?
I'm worried about me being falsely accused. I dob myself in. Like, it's people in my life have broken the law and they've not. There's been no consequences.
No punishment, no consequence, yeah. You can see how a lot of emotion, this hangover kind of feeling grows in people in society because we observe things like that, yeah. All right, let's see another one. God's laws are created by the lawmaker only to benefit all creation. Whereas on earth, the laws are created with mixed and often unpredictable results, and those results are unpredictable for creatures, for the human, for the lawmaker and the law enforcer or the police. So how do we feel about all that? What do you notice about yourself in relation to that? If we go to Rachel again and over to Karen on this side.
Just a sense of lack of trust and uncertainty.
Yeah.
I just feel it's really unfair that, some people benefit, some people don't. Just a real feeling of unfairness.
Yeah, and it's hard to trust laws when you feel like they're unfair.
Yeah, and so then obviously I'm not going to be able to trust God. I'm going to have that same feeling that God's unfair.
Yeah, cool. We come to the front to Pete. Did you have your hand up? And who else? Pierre. Yeah.
It becomes life is just all about us.
Yes.
And we forget that there's others involved or our actions.
Yeah, definitely. It's all about me. Yeah. Pierre?
I don't believe at all that if I follow God's law, there is a certain result, and I can really be sure of that.
Mm-hmm. You don't yet believe in the benefit.
Yes. I don't trust God that if I receive divine love, I will possibly become at one for certain. I don't believe this.
Yes. Yeah. Because there's so much uncertainty and unpredictability in the human law system. You get a hangover. If you just pass next to you to Max.
I get the attitude that I know better.
Yeah. You know better than the lawmaker.
In the flawed system.
Yeah. If you pass then, sorry guys, if you just keep passing, go to Hunter now.
It seems that like lower creations don't even have law. Let's say like an insect, that we find is causing us like difficulty, we can just kill it. We don't consider it having law.
And we don't consider that there's law affecting creatures. Yep. And because our laws really don't consider them, do they on earth? Yeah. Now if you pass to you to Nicholas. It's a little cluster of hands there.
Yeah, it looks like when humans go in jail, it's benefiting only to people that protects, and when they go in jail and they go outside and they do it again, so it looks it's only protecting it protects people from what they've done, but not from them, and it's not benefiting. Finally, they do it again. So
yeah, and often people enter jail in a better condition, sadly, than when they come out of it, because they go in and get an education in sin, really, oftentimes, and so yeah. Can be very disheartening to understand that. Yeah. Okay, if we come to Laureen.
I feel everyone makes mistakes. I'll just do what I can and,
hope for the best but not really believe in anything because everyone makes mistakes.
Yeah. So there's no permanence or
no permanence.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Who's got their outline in front of them? Anyone? Yeah, if we come to Alwyn, what are some of the things we've listed underneath this one? It's the third one on your outline. Is that putting you on the spot?
My erroneous beliefs.
Yes.
God's laws are a nuisance and should be ignored for the sake of personal advantage.
Yeah, who has that feeling? Yep. Yep. Any others?
What else? God's laws are just for the sake of God and don't benefit me personally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of us feel that, don't we? Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. All righty. Let's have a look at another one. So God's laws were created to maintain survivability, growth, and transformation of all matter and living creatures within the universe. That's some pretty awesome laws, isn't it? That they can operate like that. Whereas on Earth, our laws are primarily created for the purpose of being a deterrent or enforcing punishment upon the lawbreaker and to discourage the most disobedient. So really, we're dealing with the people who really want to disobey the most. The laws are really engaging with them, aren't they? And there's all this other people who just want to be law-abiding in certain areas. Remember, Jesus pointed out that none of us really want to abide all law on earth. But in certain areas, we're okay to abide this law or that law. And there's absolutely really no benefit, is there, to us for following the law. And it's hard to feel that the law is actually good for us, isn't it? Because sometimes you think, well, look, I usually abide by the speed limit, but right here, I can see they've left the road sign up and there's actually no road work happening. And now I've got to do 60 for the next 10Ks. And, you know, I'm abiding by the law, but gee whiz, you think, could they have just lifted up that thing and I'd get to town much quicker or whatever it is? Yeah, yeah. So, what do you guys feel about this? Laura and Kerry?
I've often felt that law is makes me feel controlled, restrained, restricted, submissive, passive, enslaved.
Yeah.
Like it, and it discourages who I am, my personality, everything about me.
Yes.
So it's completely opposing to how God's laws are.
Yeah, yeah. But I agree. A lot of us feel that about law, don't we? I felt like that about law, just like, man, it's just more rules that are going to restrict how I am. And yet when we hear about God's attitude and God's purpose for creating law, it's like the flip of it, isn't it? Yeah. Kerry?
I never ever considered that reward was available for obeying the law.
Yeah.
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 So that's cool.
Yeah. Yeah. If we go back to Sandra there, and on this side we'll come to Alwyn.
I just feel like I can see that God's law, that particular one, happens in nature, but I never ever think to apply it to myself.
Yeah.
I can see this happening every day almost in my life. Like, and I just don't
think
I'm part
that,
of the universe at all.
Yeah. Yeah.
It feels like.
Yeah. It's funny, isn't it? Has anyone else seen that in nature and then not thought, well, God did that for like bugs. Maybe it's for me as well. Yeah. All right. Who are we here? Alwyn, yep.
Because I feel it's going to be punishing and it's variable, I have a great fear of authority, including the fear of God as an authority.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Awesome. All right, let's keep going because we've got tons of these. Laws operate whether the creation is aware or not. So whether I know a law's operating, remember Sandra's just said, like, I've got no idea it's happening, but it's happening whether I'm aware of it or not. Whereas on Earth, the laws operate only if the police and law enforcer is aware and willing to enforce the law. How many times have you been stopped for speeding and the police officer goes, oh, you're right, hey, you know, yeah. Someone in the last group said, well, I went to court and I told the truth and I got off and it all just started from there. Now I just tell the truth and all the police officers let me off. Like, which is probably not still respecting the law, is it? It's just honouring the truth principle about breaking law, which is kind of an oxymoron. Yeah, yeah. Okay. So how do you guys feel about this fact? I'll leave it up there without the thing. So basically we can see it's only happening if someone notices. Lani, and who was on this side? If we go back to Tess, yeah.
The law is fickle and it can be manipulated.
Yeah. And if you think about this in terms of your childhood experience, wow, wasn't this a good reinforcer of the facade?
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Mum and I'll just present this and mum and dad will do this, yeah. You know? And then we think, oh, God, I'll just present this to you and you'll think I'm repentant. Doesn't work, does it?
You see what I can get away with.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, Tess?
You hardly ever have to take any notice of the law because it's not enforced very often. Yeah. So most of the time you don't have to, you can completely ignore it.
Yeah, that's a good observation. Like, how many laws are there in Australia? I mean, there's libraries of them, like, and I don't know hardly any of them. And I don't even try and find out because I just think, well, like Tess said, that what's the benefit in knowing? And I know the general society like rules, I just follow them. Whereas you can see like finding out God's laws is like there's huge benefits, isn't there? All of these principles we've been teaching you, automatically you've got all these keys to eliminating sin from your life, don't you? Yeah, which it relates to your pain. Okay, if we come back on this side to Denise and Joanne over that side.
I can see now that God's laws are just, but that's never the way that I've thought about law at all before. It's a rebellion and not just.
Yeah. Yeah. And do you find like there's been a lot of anger about law, like human law?
Yeah, rage. And I guess in me it was that one person might get the punishment that doesn't equal what I thought the crime was and someone else might get away. But I can feel up there that it is just what God's doing and I have to deal with my rebellion and the way that I thought about law before.
Yeah, yeah, cool. All right, Joanne.
That's exactly what I was going to say. I have tremendous resentment that law isn't about justice anymore, that it's about who can bargain better or who can pay the better lawyer or who has... If you're white and have a lot of money, you know, it's different than...
Yeah.
So I have a lot of anger about that as well.
Yeah, yeah. And you come from a society that's very litigious, isn't it? And it's very much about exactly the issues that you said. Yeah. Playing the facts and having the money and having the right colour skin and background and all of that. Yeah. Yeah, it's very, very damaging, isn't it? What about, did anyone come from a family where rebellion was rewarded? I did. Like, yeah, you're pretty cool if you rebel, you know? Like, don't worry, be tough. Like, and that's a big block, isn't it? And it creates, part of a hangover, saying, you know, it's actually cool and tough to ignore law when you can. Yeah. All right, let's keep going. Oh, I love this one. Okay, God's laws operate on the heart, soul, attitude, character, thoughts and emotions of the human and the action you take. Human laws operate only on the action and then only if the action's seen, processed and enforced by the law enforcer. It's such a difference, isn't it? Yeah. So how do you guys feel about that? How does it make you feel that human law is like that? Eloisa? And Paul on that side, yep.
I felt like it's really unfair, like especially from childhood.
Yeah.
And then there's a combo of like fear, anger, like sadness, because it never took into consideration all the manipulative bits that wasn't seen.
Yeah. So just like mum comes in the room, somebody's hit somebody else and that person who's doing the hitting's punished, but they didn't see all the underhanded sneaky things that like really, really built the brother up to the point where they were like, yeah, yeah.
Totally.
Yeah. Gotcha. All right, Paul.
In relation to God's laws, I feel pretty afraid because it's like I don't know if I'm breaking them or not because I'm not that aware of stuff
yeah.
which is in me and my, you know, emotions and and unknown stuff.
So who else is freaking out now that you've learned that it's like, you're really starting to feel, aren't you, this week, that it's not just the actions, it's all the other stuff that I'm trying to hide under the facade. Yeah, yeah. It's not you need to feel your feelings about it, but it's actually done for your benefit. And it helps you come out of denial, yeah, and into a place of happiness. So if we come to Patricia on this side and Nikki on that side. So if we go Nikki first and then Patricia up the front. If you just put up your hand again, Patricia. Yep.
So I've actually had it where in childhood I owned up and was like, it was me.
Yep.
And I still got like punished and stuff. And, you know, the way God works, it's like God wants you to be like that and wants you to be transparent.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, it's a big opposite, isn't it? And a lot of us have a lot of feelings of resistance to being transparent and open because of that attitude, yeah.
I think as a child it made me feel this feeling of hypocrisy and double standard sort of, because I saw my parent, who I could see was a really dark person, and then punishing me for something that I did that wasn't nearly. Like. Yeah. So I sort of said, this doesn't make sense at all. And so I sort of dismissed the whole olive law, really.
Yeah.
It just didn't make sense.
Yeah, a lot of us dismiss it right from when we're very young for that reason. Yeah. All right, let's keep going. God's laws operate consistently under all circumstances with no exceptions. That's the permanence principle, isn't it? And human laws operate differently in each country. They're inconsistently applied according to hundreds of factors. So similar, some of them Joanne was starting to point out earlier. So how do you guys feel about this inconsistency? Catherine? And on this side, if we come to Richard.
I just think God's laws, are just so good. They're just right, you know, they're just not like human laws at all, and the punishment that parents gave us and things like that, and they just seem so honest and right to me.
Yeah, they make your soul sing a little bit.
Yes, they do.
Yeah, yeah, it's nice, eh? Yeah. Richard?
It cultivates a lot of manipulation, so way out of harmony with truth.
Yeah, yeah, it really does, doesn't it? We get to be very manipulative and get to put our slant on things, and we get rewarded for that time and again, and that creates this feeling that it's a good thing. Adria?
I feel it's very dangerous, because depending on what country you go, if it's a very conservative country, for example, and you don't know the laws, you can get in trouble if it's...
You can
do things illegally that are illegal in your country.
Definitely. So it's that thing where you don't feel safe anywhere, isn't it? Because you're thinking, wow, I don't even know. Lots of you came from overseas and here, and do you know any of the laws that are in Australia? No. So it's like you could just unwittingly do something terrible. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Let's keep going because we've got to get through them. Okay. God's laws. Each law has a loving penalty if disobeyed and loving rewards when obeyed. So love is always the outcome. Human laws usually only have penalties when disobeyed, and then only if the disobedience is observed, processed, and enforced by the law enforcer. So, again, lots of similar feelings coming up about these. Who wants to share a bit of a hangover they've got there? Elvira and Anna on this side.
I feel a bit like Catherine, where I just love it, but I think I do for unloving reasons. Because I feel like, well, they apply to me, but at least they're going to apply to you as well. Yeah. You know,
that's such a good observation, Elvira. Yeah. Yeah, and you're right. It's not quite a loving attitude, isn't it? And in fact, a lot of Jesus has pointed out to me about a lot of Christians on earth actually have it in a less humble way than you do, where you say, no, they apply to me. But a lot of Christianity is about, I won't be outwardly punishing towards others because God's going to punish you, you know. So the feeling is, I want to punish that person, but there's a facade over the top of that, and just relying on this sort of wrathful God to do that. Yeah, yeah. But good observation, hey? Anna?
I just feel like you're living in constant calculation of risk versus reward.
Mm-hmm.
But now even just making the calculation in the first place is breaking the law, so it's all pointless.
Yep. Did everyone hear what Anna said? She constantly making the calculation of risk versus reward, but now she's seeing even that's sinful, that risk versus reward calculation. Yeah. It gets very tiring as well, that kind of thing. Yeah. All right, thanks, guys. Okay. Let's look at another one. God's laws, the penalties and rewards are loving, consistent and predictable. Human laws, many penalties are actually unloving. Obedience is rarely rewarded and the results are usually unpredictable. So human laws, when we say the penalties are unloving, often, like as Nicholas pointed out, sometimes people go into jail and there's actually no loving rehabilitation for the sinful attitude, is there? And actually it doesn't really help the person who was harmed by the crime either, does it? So it just ends up being a very unloving system. So how do you guys feel about all of that? Fabio? And who haven't we heard from? Courtney?
I just feel it's like unpredictability, because when you're a kid, you know, you probably, your dad might come in and be angry for one thing and then your mum might be upset for another thing and then you don't know what was consistent about that. Like you probably didn't do anything wrong or you did. And then you go out into the world and it's just different to what they taught as well. So I always put that towards God, you know, like it's not going to be, did I do something wrong? Didn't I do something? Like, I don't know a lot of the time.
There's a lot of confusion and fear surrounding law. Yeah. Courtney?
It probably comes from childhood, but I find myself, like, when I watch movies about, you know, people getting different treatment because of their race or their orientation or something like that, I find myself feeling pretty upset about that. So I think I've got probably some resentment and sadness about it.
Yeah, for sure. Okay. If we come to Laureen.
I still struggle with loving penalties because of the way the penalties were always handled. So when I put loving and penalties
together,
I go, oh yes.
How does that work? Yeah. You're going to hear about compensation this afternoon and that's going to sort you out. Yeah. But if you look in your outline, what are some of the things that we listed underneath there? Isn't there something about like feeling like, well, my special case or my special group or my special race actually should get off? A lot of us who feel like, well, I was sexually abused as a kid, so I'm allowed to hate on men forever. You know, that's really an example of this, isn't it? Yeah. All right. Okay, when it comes to God's laws, each law deals with and addresses both the cause, so that's relating to why we used our will to disobey or obey the law, and the effect, so the fact that we did use our will in a certain way and there was a consequence. Whether it be a loving way we used our will or an unloving way we used our will, there's always cause and effect. So God's laws deals with both of those things. Human laws only deal with the disobedience, but as we've mentioned earlier, doesn't actually fully address the reason why we did it, but just provides penalties as a sort of stick to force obedience. And it doesn't address the cause or reward loving action. So some of this stuff you guys have already been mentioning how you feel about. Any other things that come up? If we go Joanne.
I have great difficulty when you mentioned about the person who was the victim that for the crime, that it's compensated with money in the U.S. especially. Mm. And I just can't wrap my head around that. Like, it makes it all very dirty. And
do you sort of feel like someone's paying to get away with something?
Yeah, and that the person who was harmed gets money for that, and it's just kind of twisted.
Yeah. Although if you think about money as a resource, it might give that person some more resources to do some things to heal themselves with.
Possibly, yes. Yeah.
Didn't convince Joanne there.
I didn't know. Yeah. I'm going to consider that. Thank you. I will consider that.
No worries. Now, who's got their outline open to this example and would read a couple of the ones that we had there on the list? Sherry?
I should be able to change my action rather than have to correct my attitude.
Yeah, that's a big one that I wanted to highlight with you guys. So a lot of us have this feeling, and it's where we hear even divine truth and then we go, well, I'll just change all my actions. Who's done that in the last 5 years or so? And it just generates more facade, doesn't it? And so you have to work through more self-delusion to get back to the real heart of the issue. Yeah. What's the second one on the list?
I should be able to avoid recognition of the harm I've caused to others and the environment.
Yes. Yeah. That's another big one, isn't it? Where, and that's a big part of repentance, is actually not only recognizing, hey, the cause, but really wanting to be aware of the effect. Yeah. Yeah. And what's our third one?
God's laws are anally retentive and nitpicking.
I could have missed that one. Who feels like that? Geez, like looking at my thoughts, my, you know, my intentions, even if I like move a little pinky in one direction, God knows what. Yeah. 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 All right. Thanks, Sheridan. Yeah. Okay. All right. So, can you start to understand a little bit why we've used this sort of analogy of being drunk and having a hangover? You can see we're carrying a lot of baggage about law, aren't we? And it is impacting on how open our heart is to feeling about God's law and living by God's law. So we've said there that we're drunk on our own perception of law. And we see God's law similarly to how we see human law. We impose our perceptions of humans' law onto God's laws. And this again, as we keep mentioning, this is the cause of our pain and suffering. When we don't live in harmony with God's laws, we automatically sin, we create our own pain and suffering. Which is good to know in a way, isn't it? Because it's all under our control. Yeah. Yeah. Alrighty. What we need to understand is that God's laws are very different to human laws. Thank goodness, hey? Given some of the things we've talked about. Although, remember, not all human law is in disharmony with God's law. It's easy to skip that fact when we feel a bit angry at authority. Yeah. Human resistance to God's law is based upon flawed viewpoints of love and truth that come from our childhood, parental, and societal experience. And probably we want to highlight to you this childhood experience, because really, if you drill down into it, you're going to find that even a lot of your attitudes to societal authority come from your earliest experiences. And if we keep treating God's laws like human laws, we continue to remain unhappy and in pain. So there it is, you know. We know if I keep going down this track, I know the results. And hopefully that's a bit of a motivation to keep learning about God's principles and laws. Yeah. Okay. So we've pretty much said to you guys in both Jesus' presentation, he really highlighted this, didn't he? And now, again, you've all been helping me highlight that there's an enormous difference, this big gap between God's laws and human laws. And that each one of our hangovers is actually a block to being in harmony with God's laws. So each one of those emotions that we have about authority and law on earth actually constitutes a block. So we're going to need to work through each of them. Sin is generated by the desire to avoid discovering and obeying God's laws. And again, this relationship between sin and our pain and suffering. And remember, it's not just our pain and suffering when we sin. There's pain and suffering for others when we continue to live in sin. Yeah. Yeah. Alrighty. Well, that's all we wanted to highlight with you guys about the hangover. Now you're going to have a really good opportunity to have a lot of your questions answered. We're going to have a 10-minute break. Jesus will be back to do the Q&A session with you. And then we'll get on to some compensation. We'll finish off your order principles this afternoon. But if we come back at 12:45, that'd be great. If you have any quick final questions, you've got about 2 minutes to write them on the sheets before we grab them for Jesus to have a look at before the next session. Okay? So thanks, guys.